Hey, what's going on? It's J.K. Swopes, a.k.a. St. Joe from SoundsOfGear.com. We're doing the first a native experience where we're taking a look at some native instruments, plugins, synth samplers, goodies, noise-making contraptions. Being that Native Instruments is such a fine establishment and, you know, a nice, reputable company, I figured I'd get a little bit more professional, so I threw on the tie for all the people that like the professional presentation. So, I hope you like it. I threw it on just for you. Anyway, today we're going to be looking at Core 2, their next generation workstation. If you didn't notice, a lot of their stuff is pointing towards Core. I'm going to tell you why. First of all, Core by itself is an instrument. It has a massive contact FM8 reactor, guitar rig, and absinthe sound engines inside of it already. So you can't pull up those plugins with this if you don't have the plugins, but you have the sound sculpting generation capabilities of all those engines. And it comes with 500 sounds made just for Core, and each of those 500 sounds have 8 pre-programmed variations that'll change stuff like filtered and all that different type of stuff. Anyway, so first of all, it's an instrument by itself. Second, all the Native Instruments libraries, I mean plugins like Absinthe, Massive, FM8, Battery, Contact, Reactor, Absinthe, I think I said that already, FM8, you know, whatever, they're plugins. Those presets can be loaded into Core, so Core, see all those, any of the Native Instruments that are Core sound ready, it'll see those and pull those into your Core browser. Now what's so sexy about the Core browser? You got all these sounds, but it's easy to find them because you find them based on characteristic. So you pick a piano, you say, I want a piano that's sample based, that's dark, that's arpeggiated, that's good for polka. They may not have polka in there, but you see what I'm saying. You pick it based on characteristic, and it narrows things down so you can get closer to specifically what you want, then you can tweak to your heart's content. So not only does it have it's an instrument, and it can hold all your Native Instrument sounds. You can also expand it with Core sound packs. So if you don't want to go out, say you like the sounds in Core that are made with the Absinthe engine, but you don't want to go buy the Absinthe plugin, you just want some more Absinthe sounds. You go to the website, you buy a Absinthe sound pack, either the best of Absinthe that gives you the best 200 patches from all the versions of Absinthe, or you can buy like the brand new Absinthe sounds. Same for all the other ones, FM8, and they even just got brand new stuff based on the Core engine, the Core plugin itself. So you can buy those little sound packs. They're like from like $59 up to $100, something like that. But I think that's pretty dope, you know. So if you have Core, I mean, you got the expansion capabilities. Even if you don't want to go out and buy the full plugins, you can just buy the packs to expand it. Also, it's a VST host, so you can hold all your VSTs in there if you want to. You know, so say you want to have all your, you know, Native Instrument sounds, and then you want to have some other of your favorite stuff in there. You can load those up easy and mix it just like you do with the Core sounds. You can even bring in the presets. So I'm sure you know all that. I'm sure you've seen some of the videos. But I'm telling you, this is the reason why I like. I'm not going to a bunch of technical. I'm not going to go over every single thing that it does. I'm just telling you why I like it as a guy coming from hardware and why I see it's useful. So basically, like I said, that's basically what Core is. I want to show you a little bit of it just to kind of give you a taste of what it is and why I like it. So let's put that up, then we're going to kind of take a look.
Alright, so this is the Core interface. I didn't do the screenshot thing. I kind of did it this way. You know, that's how I get down sometimes. Anyway, so basically right here you got your type, piano, drums, strings, guitar, your type or instrument. Then, you know, you can dig deeper. Say if I want a mallet, I can go into a deeper vibraphone, marimba, xylophone, different stuff like that. Let's do a new performance so I can have a clean slate. Then you can say mode if you want an arpeggiated, synthetic, FM, physical model, granular, different stuff like that. Then if you have any sound packs, you can pick from you can pick from specifically those sound packs. And then you got your genre, so orchestral, femme, dance, hip-hop, funk, reggae, Latin, ethnic, folk, or whatever. So let's say we wanted a synth lead that was a sync-style lead that was dry, no chord, say it was just dry. So we go over here, you can see it narrowed it down to, I think I only got three of them over there. I'll pull that up and let's see if it's what I was looking for. So it's a synth that's succinctly described. So that's pretty cool. Say I wanted a tempo synced, let's say a classic lead that's tempo synced. I can pull up this here, BMX driver. And I want to show you something up here. These if you see they let you change the, this is where the eight variations are real quick. So you can go in there and change it. By the way, I'm just using the software version. There's a hardware version that has these type of controls on the hardware controller. But I like the software, it's cool. So.